Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. As you see right here, I've got this two layers of cardboard that are nice and straight. And then I have this piece of poster board here. It's got ghost lines on it. I found the dead center. I pinned it. And I've got this stuff for doing needlepoint type of stuff, arts and crafts. My wife gave it to me. I do have a compass, but in order to draw this fast and have this set up, well, this is a system I use anyway. And I can mark my dots to show everything quick. I said I'd go ahead and show you how to draw this out pretty quick. What I've done is I've made my measurements to the inside edge of the brake disc, like right here, this edge. And then to where the edge of the magnet will be, the outer edge, the eighth inch lip, all these marks are right here. I have these measurements over here. The total width all the way across from edge to edge, like here, I have these down, which is 282 millimeters, or 11 1/8. And I have 272 to the next dot, which is 10 15/16. And this one here is 176 millimeters at 6 inches and 15/16. And 158 millimeters, 6 1/4 inches. Well, all divided in half, I wind up with 141 millimeters, which is 5 5/8. We're going with, this is radius now, 138.5 millimeters, which is 3 15/32. This dot right here is 88 millimeters, which is 3 15/32. And between these two dots will be our magnets. And 79 millimeters, which is 3 1/8 inches. And while I draw this stuff out, and see, I got these color coded. Black is going to be the edge of the brake disc, the metal. I'm going to go ahead and change the camera angle and bring this down a little bit closer for you. Okay, I believe that's good enough. Alrighty, so quickly, we'll draw these out. That's one. And this is the other one in black. And you see, well, why draw all of this? Well, number one, you can't just start by winding coils. You have to find out what the size of the inside of the coil is going to be. And you got to make sure they're all going to fit. You're going to be wasting a lot of money on wire and a lot of time. And then you're going to have to wind up making another coil winder. This is our eighth inch lip. Brand new markers. Seem to put a lot of ink here. It's alright. I'm going to go ahead and use it anyway. There's some spots here where it doesn't show all that. A lot of the rest of the measurements on the inside and like that we'll put on here when we need them. For right now, I think that's good. I'm going to go ahead and use a pencil as well. I don't think it's going to show up on the black unless I have the light shining on it just right. That'll make a little bit more finer of a line that I can measure with. I know you can't see it on the camera, but I can. At least my center point doesn't change each time I draw a line. There we go. I'll get a finer line for make. And you can use this template to draw another one anytime. Out to the outside. And this is pinned into two layers of cardboard. As long as you don't pull too hard, that'll stay there for you nicely. Alright, we'll find out the inside shape of our coil winder so that our coils will wind up the right size and actually fit within their pie shape that they're supposed to fit in. Try to wind your coils first and then design everything else around it is going to cause you a lot of grief. This is the first thing that you really need to do is sit down with paper and plan. Okay, as I said in a previous video, number one, you have to mark, this is not the brake disc we're using, but you have to mark one of your holes as top dead center. So you can find out when this one, this rotor has magnets facing north, the opposite one has to be south. Now if I go 1/5 the way around, and I line these things up and go to put them on, I'll have a magnet here and a magnet here, and they're not lining up. So you got to mark one of your holes as top dead center. Now also I set around here, as you can see, I got the little fins inside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one divided out real nice. It was divisible by 12 for 12 magnets. Also divisible by 9 for 9 coil placements. And that's great. So I use this as my protractor. I have a protractor, but if you have the right disc, and they have a number of the little fins inside, air vents that equal that, you can use it as a protractor. But for ease here, I set this dead center on my ghost lines, which I have one here, here, here. You can barely see them. You might not be able to see them on the camera. I set this in the middle. I lined it up perfect where the top one was sitting here. And I marked all those all the way around for my angles. And I have already set them down. And I've also marked where top dead center should be. I'll be drawing my magnets in here shortly. There we are. A little bit of rust. Nasty. From here out, I'll come from the center line here. And I'll put the pin back in, lay my ruler against it, and draw straight out. Because the size of the pin is about the width of the pencil mark. I'll take the ruler right over to the edge. Matter of fact, we'll do that right now. And we'll get this drawn out and get on the way with it. Okay, I'm going to draw from here straight on out. It's far enough. It's going to have to go outside the dimensions of the rotor because the coils do. And that's what we're planning with these lines. Draw that straight up. That's far enough. Draw that out. A little bit more. There we go. Draw that out. Thinking about the width of the pen. And draw it out. Lines have thickness, and they make a difference in your measurements. On my other drawing, I had so many measurements and lines on there, I didn't expect to be able to come across on camera to tell you what each one of them were. These are the important ones. And now we get to draw our coil dimension. For that, we have the little pieces of 14 gauge wire that I plan on using. All right, in this step, I have actually measured both sides just to make sure it's perfectly in the center in between these lines. And I use a fine line Sharpie and draw the sides. The ends are okay. These lines towards the middle are going to be adapted to make, because if I wound this out here, my coil would be all the way out to here, and trying to set them side by side, they wouldn't fit. So this is going to have to be pulled in, and that's going to give me a shape that cuts some of this magnet shape off, and we'll adapt that, and that way we'll know the inside dimensions of our coil winder. The set of plans that I took my information from was a tested and proven plan. They had 12-inch magnet rotors, I'm speaking. The rotors I'm using are 11 inches. That means at the same RPM that the magnets are passing the coils at a slightly slower speed. Being about 10% smaller, it's off by 10% on the speed. So I went to this program of mine called RPM at miles per hour. And sorry, you can't see the words at the top of the screen. It's got cut off. That's my monitor's fault. Anyway, that says diameter of the blade. The diameter of the blade that they used was 10 foot. I put in 10 foot. Their circumference is 31.415 feet. The blades we carve are 4.5 tip speed ratio. And we'll start the miles per hour off at 1. What they were talking as their cut-in speed for charging is about 140 RPM. Well, here in my program, it says 1 mile per hour, and we're looking at 12 RPM. That's the same all over. Each time I do this, it's going to increase 1 mile per hour. 2 miles per hour at 25 RPM. 37 RPM at 3. 50 at 4 RPMs. 63 at 5 miles per hour, and 75 RPM at 6 miles per hour. Let's scoot on up here. There's 138 RPM at 11 miles per hour. So we're figuring 11 miles per hour for charging. I wanted it to be a little bit lower than that, so I'm going to increase the number of windings on my coil by about 10%, and that ought to bring it down to about 10 miles per hour. Plus, if I make my prop at 9 foot, that's going to give me pretty close to about another 10, maybe 9%. So let's test that out. END. And we'll start the application again. 9 foot blade gives me 28 feet in circumference and a tip speed ratio of 4.5 again and 1 mile per hour. Let's scan on down. At 10 miles per hour, I'm looking at 140 RPM, just like I said. So there's the other 10. So I'm figuring right around 9 miles per eight to nine miles per hour, I ought to be able to get my cut-in speed, which will be at a little bit lower RPM. Getting down here at 11 miles per hour, where we were with the 10 foot, we're looking at 154. So a smaller prop spins faster, 10% smaller, would knock it down about 10%. So I'm changing mine down to about 20% by adding about 10% more turns. Instead of 70 turns on mine, I'm going to 77 turns. And also a 1 foot smaller prop, which is not going to absorb as much power total out of the wind, but it will get my cut-in speed a little bit early in the amount of wind that I will have out here. Our winds around here are anywhere from 5 to 15 miles per hour on the average, staying pretty most about 10, and other days are really kicking up. Like tomorrow's going to be 10 to 20 miles per hour all day, and some gusts that are going to go a little bit higher. Too bad I ain't got this built by then. I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. All right, and here's my notes on my designs here. From the designs I took and found, we're looking at 6 to 7 pounds of wire, 200 degrees Celsius, and double insulated. For a 12-volt machine at a 10-foot prop with a 12-inch rotor, we're looking at two strands of 14-gauge wire, which is close to about 11-gauge when you put it together. And they have 36 turns. If I was going to do that, I'd have to make that about 40 turns, because 10% of 36 is 3.6, which would make that about 39.6. We'll call it 40 turns. Close enough. And for a 24-volt machine, which is I'm going to do, they were using 14-gauge wire with 70 turns. Well, add 10%, well, same as taking that zero off, makes that a 7. And we took that to 76 to 77 turns. And for a 48-volt machine, they were using 17-gauge wire with 140 turns, which if you added 10% and you were going to do a 48-volt machine using 17-gauge wire, you'd wind up with 154 turns per coil. And it should fit in the same amount of space that we have here. Anyway, we're going to get back to design. These were some tips, just something I wanted to show you on why and how things are a little different if you decided to use the same web page as I did to get your information. These are the adjustments down here. 40 turns for a 12-volt machine of two strands of 14, 77 turns of one strand of 14-gauge for a 24-volt machine, and for a 48-volt machine, 154 turns of 17-gauge AWG American wire gauge, magnet wire.